Hello, Funhouse Church family. This is Stella, and I'm so happy you're here. Welcome, welcome, welcome. It's a beautiful day here in Nashville, Tennessee, and I've been thinking about this scripture today, and actually for 2 or 3 days, because we've had a very unusual week, and a week of change, and a week of challenge. But I was reading in 2 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 9 and 10, and I'll share this with you because it meant a lot to me. And Paul is talking about a vision that he had of the Lord coming to him. And he says here, "And he said unto me, My grace is sufficient for thee, for my strength is made perfect in weakness. Most gladly, therefore, will I rather glory in my infirmities, that the power of Christ may rest upon me. Therefore, I take pleasure in infirmities, in reproaches, in necessities, in persecutions, in distresses, for Christ's sake. For when I am weak, then I am strong." And, you know, that says so much to me because I think, you know, when we stand up for what we believe in, whether it's about our faith or whether it's about other things that come across our lives in day-to-day social interaction, and especially on social media, the things that people can say to us when they don't know us at all, and the things that they judge us for, you know, that's okay, because if we're standing for what we believe is the truth and have compassion in our own hearts, which is what Jesus came to teach us, to have compassion, to love one another, because the two commandments that he gave us, only two, he didn't give us those other 10. Moses wrote those down. They were, you know, given to him from God, and that's in the Old Testament. But Jesus had two for us, and those two were to love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, soul, mind, and strength, and to love your neighbor as yourself. Now, I think if we're going to break that down, if we're going to love our neighbor as ourselves, we should treat other people like we would like to be treated, not the way we feel like treating people. We should treat everyone just as we would like to be treated. And if we really love God with our heart, soul, mind, and strength, then we're going to always refer back to that and to what God is, which the scripture says that God is love. It says it's the spirit of love as well. So if we can keep a spirit of love and compassion in our hearts, then we're not going to be that concerned about all the persecution and all the judgment that other people do to us. We do defend ourselves. That's our human nature. But we don't have to get too carried away with it. God bless you.